Hello my dear students, this is A.K. Gupta, your English faculty, Arts School, Bansur. So my dear students, as we know that we have completed present indefinite tense advanced uses in last and previous videos. Okay, now today we are going to complete the next topic, which name is present continuous tense advanced uses. And I know very well that you will be familiar with the basic rules of present continuous tense. Okay, so in this video we will crack only advanced uses. I hope you will get easily and you will be enjoy this. Now let's start. Lesson number is second, present continuous tense advanced uses. Rule first, to express an action which is going on continuously while speaking. Mean to say, that means any action which is going on continuously while speaking. If I am speaking anything and that action is going on continuously, that means this action is denoted to present continuous tense. For example, I am speaking before you means at the time I am speaking before you means when I am speaking, that time I was telling you that I was speaking. Okay, second thing, at the time I am teaching you online video. Okay, so at the time whatever I said, that action is going on. Okay, if same thing is here, if I will say to you that I'm writing on board, that means I'm writing on board and the work and the action is going on. He is teaching English there. Suppose a teacher is teaching their side at the time while speaking, so that is a present continuous tense. Okay, next one is here, to express an action whose beginning and completion are not known. It's mean, here is an action, okay, which a beginning means when it has been started, don't know, and when it has been completed, don't know, means when it has started and when it has completed, we don't know, and how much long time it will take to complete or fulfill this work, we don't know surely. So because of this, we will use in this present continuous tense. So we can write some examples. Let's see. First example, I am writing a novel, means novel. A novel I am writing means I don't know when have I started, and I don't know also this thing when it will be completed. So both the thing, if I don't know, so that's mean it will be included in the present continuous tense. Next, if I will give you example like this, that boy or child is weeping, that means we don't know, child is small child, okay. So we don't know when he has started to weep, and we don't know when he will stop weeping. I know, okay, I think you are getting this child. If he is child, so we cannot be sure on that matter, then when he will stop weeping. Okay, so both sentences is denoted to present continuous advanced uses rule number second, that means whose beginning and completion are not known. Okay, I hope, let's see, you are watching this old video and you are watching at the board that whatever I have written, and I hope you have understood these things whatever I have taught you at the time. Okay, and next third and fourth rule, let's start. So my dear students, now next rule is rule number 3, to express mood of irritation. Okay, mood of irritation means which things or which action can you which action or which thing can be irritated. means you are not feeling good and better by these actions, those actions which all are irritating you. So means, suppose for example, all of you are making noise, so that's irritation. Making noise, that's irritation. Many times the teacher will say you that is, please stop talking, don't speak more, don't speak loudly, don't make noise. So the teacher's being here, irritation, feeling irritation. So that time if anybody is feeling irritation, so that time it will be used in the present continuous tense. I think you're getting. Okay, next, if I would like a example, so we can see some examples here. Now first, you are making noise, okay, that means it's a irritation. You, they are speaking loudly, okay, they are speaking loudly. So both sentences are telling us about the irritation, means in both sentences they are feeling irritation by their action. Because of this, it has been used in the present continuous tense. Now rule number 4 is here, that means to express temporary action. So my dear friends, what is the temporary action? Temporary action, we can say those actions which all are we are doing for the short time, for the short period, not we are doing for the long time and we will not expend more and more time on these things. So we can say the temporary action. For example, if I will write here, I am studying math for IIT. So I think you know very well, if I am studying math for IIT, if for IIT I am studying math, that's mean I will have to complete within 2 years if I have taken foundation course and I am studying 11th class. So 11th and till 12th I will study math only for the ITI, because when I will give entrance exam for the ITI and if I will crack the exam and I will get the admission in the IIT college, so it means the previous work has been completed. Okay, so we can say in the simple form, this is a temporary action which we have completed within 2 years or 1 year. Okay, so it is a temporary action. Next, I hear, let's change into he. He is teaching English speaking course. Now here, English speaking course has been provided by a teacher. That means he is teaching English speaking course. If English speaking course, you know very well, the all institutes are providing this course for the short term period. For example, this is provided only for 3 months, and it might have been you might have seen these things anywhere that it has been used only for 6 months. So it has been provided for 3 or 6 months. So that is a short term period. Short term period, it has been completed within 3 or 6 months. So we can say this sentence belongs to present continuous rule number 4, that some temporary action. Okay, so next we will continue. Let's see. So my dear students, now we are going to complete the next rule, rule number 5. Here, to express intention or likelihood could exist. To express intention or likelihood action. Now here is what is the intention? Intention means to do any work for a purpose. Means if you have any purpose to complete any action, if you have a purpose to do any action, suppose I am going to meet my friend. So that is the intention that I am going to meet my friend. Here is another example. If I will say that I am going to market to eat burger. So that is the intention. And my purpose to eat burger. So there is intention. That is called intention. Similarly, likelihood. Likelihood means as a possibility. As a possibility. So possibility means if you have any action to do and you are not sure for that, but it may be there is a possibility. And for action you are not sure that what will happen or what will you do. Okay, so that is called a possibility. Suppose I will say that I am going to die. It may be possible, and it might be possible that if I will go there to die, it may be possible that I will drop this decision. Definitely it may be possible that I felt a fear to die. Suppose a train is approaching to me and I thought that I should be hit to the train and the train will hit me, so I will die. Okay, so while reaching the train, arrival train, so I saw, thereafter I felt so fear, and in the fearness I will think I'll drop the idea to die. So at this situation, if you have any possibility in any action, so definitely you will leave this thing. So according to this rule, we can say some example like this. I am going to meet him. Okay. Next example, she is going to die. And it may be possible that I will teach you, if I will say a sentence like I am going to teach you, but here is not a sure thing that I will teach you definitely. It may be possible that I will drop this idea and I will go back in my staff room. I will not teach you. Okay, it may be possible that anybody called me, don't teach, and you will take this period next time. So maybe possibility means here is some possibilities to complete the sentences, to complete this law. Okay, so we have completed this action with possibility. Okay, I think you are getting. So where you are not sure for those things, so that time you will drop this idea and you will not continue those things. Okay, now let's continue. Rule number six is here to express changes, trends, and it's meant to express changes, trends in any action. If we will find changes or trends in any sentence, okay, so that time you will include these 10 things or these tenses, your these translations into the present continuous tense. How will you rectify that it's changes or trends? Okay, changes means there is something or little bit change, like that the bouncer is becoming a city. Okay, So that is a changes, because Bansal we know very well, this is a village, and village is becoming a city. It's changing into city. So thereafter, trends like boys are wearing shorts clothes. I think you must have seen, definitely. I think you have must have seen these things, that all the students, all the new generations of boys and girls are wearing the shorts clothes, and this is the generation, it has been changed. So according to this rule, we have completed in the present continuous tense. I think you have understood, and for the next video, we will meet in the next video. Thank you.